To get started, you want to arrange your cords in order. This bracelet has 6 long cords and these should be in positions 1, 2, 3, 6, 7 and 8. These should be 1/2 foot long for every inch of bracelet required, depending on the fastening you're using. The short cords should be in positions 4 and 5. These cords will only be worked over, so they should be long enough to wrap around the wrist 2 to 3 times. For this pattern, the colour layout should be symmetrical, with colour 1 in positions 1 and 8, colour 2 in positions 2 and 7, and colour 3 in positions 3 and 6. The cords in positions 4 and 5 can be any colour as they won't show up in the pattern. This is a 3-row repeat pattern using square knots. So to begin, you can take the cords on the outside and just put these out of the way. And you're going to start with the cords in positions 3 and 6. And you want to work a square knot over the cords in positions 4 and 5. And then once you've done that, you want to put the cords you just used as your working cords with the other holding cords. And you want to take the next colour in your sequence. So you want the cords in positions 2 and 7. And you want to work a square knot over the ones in between. And then following with the theme, what you did with your last set of working cords, you want to clip these to the board, and then taking your last two cords in positions 1 and 8, you want to do a square knot over the rest of the cords. And this is the sequence you want to repeat all the way down. So you want to go back to what you did in row 1, and taking the cords in positions 3 and 6, again, just using these, you want to do a square knot over the cords in positions 4 and 5. And then clipping these to the board with the rest of the holding cords. You want to take the next two cords in positions 2 and 7, and again, work a square knot over the rest of the cords in between. And then clip these to the board as well, and take the last two cords in positions 1 and 8 and do your last square knot, making sure to catch it underneath the last square knot that you did. And then back to row 1, and just keep repeating this all the way down. And when you're finished, you should end up with something that looks like this. So I've done braided tie-ons to do a tie-on fastening, but you could do whichever fastening you prefer. And that is your completed macrame bracelet.